Well, folks, I've got a treat for you today. I'm here with Simon Feasey, who is New Zealand's Ken Climo, if you like. He is 10 times New Zealand champion, current champ as well as Australian champ, and also 2002 mini disc golf world champ, I believe, Simon.
Yep, that's right, thanks.
And well, also,
mini disc golf is a great game.
And also at one point, I think, world masters distance champ as well.
Yep.
Outstanding. So we're doing it in the bag with Simon today because he's just taken out yet another tournament down at Taupo the last weekend. So Simon, tell us a little bit about what you got in your bag.
Right, where to start? I guess the mini, you know, the most important disc in the bag. I mean, it's quite ironic that I started this tournament this weekend and I had a big bag full of minis because I have all my favourites and I'm never quite sure which ones I want to use. And this is one of my favourites, a really nice stamp. But we get out there on the first hole, I've had my first shot, and I go and I think, oh shit, I've forgotten a mini, so I end up borrowing one. So anyway, it's back in the bag now, you know, it's in there nice and safe and sound. With respect to putters, I carry a variety of putt and approach discs. I have here, this is one of the few Discraft discs that I use, and this is a soft focus. And I really enjoy it. It's got a nice little bead, feels good in the hand. Slightly overstable, good for approach shots.
Looks like you've had it a while, Simon.
Oh yeah, I've had it for a while, though they beat up pretty quick, which is not a bad thing for these putters, but this still stays pretty stable.
Only for putting, or would you approach with that as well?
No, I also approach with this. In fact, it's got a real nice stability to it, so I can give it a good toss in the wind, and it's not gonna turn over.
How much power can you put on that? You'd put it out 90 metres?
Yep, I can give this a good hard throw if I need to. Then I've got one of my old favourites.
It's a naked what?
It's an ABR.
Holy moly, man, let's have a look.
From the year 2000.
Let me have a look at some, just give us a look at the edge on that thing.
It's had a few beats.
Yeah, a few.
Needless to say, this turns over like nobody's business. So,
yeah, it's pretty flippy.
Yeah, it's pretty flippy, and it used to be my preferred putter again because it's quite soft. But now it sort of resides in the bag a little bit just because, you know, it's got no other home. So I like it around, probably don't use it that much.
So where would you use that? Downwind, Simon?
Yeah, absolutely, downwind, and good for little finesse turnover shots and things that I don't want a lot of speed. Just, you know, sort of
floaty,
stepping out wide and just little float shots.
And it will just flatten out as it hits the ground for you.
All sort of turnover type shots.
Nice.
I have another. While we're on a sort of putting approach, this is a disc that we make ourselves called the Tui, and what I love about this disc is it's just that little bit faster, similar to sort of a classic rock in shape.
Yep.
And
they're a lovely disc actually.
And it holds a very nice anti line and it won't flex back.
You throw that in a heavy weight, that's a heavy one, isn't it?
Yeah, this is a heavy weight.
You also do a 150?
Yeah, we do this in a full range from about 140 through to 175.
Yeah. Jay's got a heap of the 150s and she really likes them.
Yep. So no, they're a beautiful disc. I use it a lot for approaching anywhere that requires it. To hold an annie, but you don't want to have to put too much power into it.
Yeah.
Because a lot of other discs, otherwise, as soon as you take the power off, they fall out of the sky. This I can just put in just a reasonably soft straight shot, and it's just going to bend nicely.
They've got a nice amount of glide, those two.
Nice amount of glide. Really good alternative if you want to need a bit more speed, a bit more distance than that. And finally, I've got this, which is just a real stable. It's an old APX putter.
That's Millennium, is it?
APX, I think it was Discraft.
Discraft.
APX, yeah. This was just given to me by someone, and I just like it more for the hyzer lines, and for the approach, short hyzer dumps and stuff like that. And I've snagged heaps of chains with this disc from sort of 30-40 meter range, where it just, you know, I can just float it around corners and drop it in.
Nice.
And it's another. It's kind of like the opposite to the Tui.
Yeah.
But it's not overstable, but it holds a nice stable line. So that's it in terms of my short discs. Then for my medium fairway drivers, I'm a big fan of the Crow.
Yeah.
A Crow or an Arcturus. I don't have one in my bag. We make an Arcturus. An Arcturus is just a bit straighter, a bit more. You know, it's really good for the straight throws. I like to play with a little bit of shank. So what I like about these Crows is when they're new, You can put a little bit of shank on them, they hold a nice line and they fade back.
Yep.
So they're a nice, very dependable disc.
And what plastics have you got in the crow there?
Are they this is a first run star.
Yeah.
I use the star plastic on there, don't bother with the R Pro. Just too unpredictable for me, beats up too fast.
Yeah, I've thrown an R Pro, they do feel very nice.
Yeah. They're a nice feeling disc, and I think if you took a new one out of the bag every couple of tournaments, you'd probably...
You'd do well.
You'd do well, but I like these have got longevity. I've had multiple aces with them.
Yeah, it looks like it.
And, they're good discs in my bag.
So you've got one new one and one slightly older crow there?
I have sort of another one as well, a backup one, which is always in training. So, finally, I've got one stingray, which initially was quite stable, but as it's got a little bit more beaten up, it tends to turn over.
Mm.
But this fly is very similar to the Tui, but just faster.
Yeah. You don't find it particularly understable?
No. It's a star. It's a star stingray. Yeah. I've seen some of the other stingrays that are very understable.
This one
I can give it a good crank, and especially when it was new, it would stay dead flat. It wouldn't turn over at all.
Oh, okay. Because I've got a champion stingray. It was the first golf disc I ever got was a stingray.
Yeah.
And of course, I didn't realise it was an understable disc at the time because I couldn't put enough speed on it. But now. It's definitely -3. If I want something to hold a hard right line in a mid-range, sort of under 100 metres, it'll definitely hold it.
No, I use the Roadrunner for that.
Yep.
I mean, it is a longer distance, but if I do happen to want a long tailing right drive, I'll pull out the Roadrunner.
Yep.
You need to give them enough height to work with, obviously.
Yep.
So that's my understable discs. Then I have a couple of discs. I do actually have another one here that Barry gave me, Barry Schultz, which is pretty cool.
Captain America. Yeah.
Pro Wraith. I normally carry a number of Pro Wraiths. I've only got two in my bag at the moment, but of varying different beaten upness, and I love them for driving. There's another one Barry gave me, and this one here is very understable. Holds a big ante, huge high, fast ante.
Yeah.
You can get a big turn around a tree.
Used to be my favourite disc, the Wraith.
This one's more stable. And I really like the Pro Wraiths. I like them more than the Star Wraiths. I used to throw Star Wraiths.
Yep.
So that's those two. Then I've got my flippier drivers. And I love these Raptors, these first run Raptors that I made. And you can see they're all a bit cut up, but they still fly beautifully.
So once again, Simon, this is one of your discs.
Yep. This is a disc that we make, and it's a very durable polyurethane, quite firm, but it's a lovely fast disc.
It is fast.
Up. And so you can, I put this out, I use it typically for low tunnels, and anywhere where I want to play the S shot. This is a beautiful S-ing disc,
so,
and you can give it a good hyzer, it'll pop up, flies very fast, flattens. We'll even rock over a bit at high speed.
If you overpower it.
If you overpower it, and then it'll turn back at the end.
So well, it certainly flew pretty nicely, that one I threw last night.
It's not a bad flick disc either. You can flick that as well. And then there's the other Discraft disc, which Damien gave me.
Oh, now that's your super flippy nuke.
Yeah, this is a flippy nuke. And this is the disc that I've thrown the furthest.
That's the disc you threw down at Queenstown, almost all the way down to the Garden of Eden, pool of Eden.
Yeah, that's right. I put it down there, and then I also threw one even bigger, just mucking around afterwards. Which we estimated was somewhere around 180 meters. So
yeah, it was still hit the trees when it was still 5 meters in the air. Yeah.
So this one definitely has got some legs if you put it up there and get it right and get a good snap.
Yeah.
Probably. 20, 30 metres further than anything else in my bag. So it's really, you really got, but of course, with the extra distance comes the unpredictability.
Yes.
If I'm out there and there's a little bit of a headwind,
no
I go
good.
Straight back in the bag.
No good. What do you throw into a headwind, Simon?
Typically, I play with Excaliburs.
Excals?
Yep.
Now that's probably, we should actually mention about an Excal, because I've got a couple of Excals at home that I got in the vague hope that I'd be able to straighten them out, but I don't have enough arm speed to straighten an Excal. Mm-hmm. Pretty much they fly straight for about 30 metres and then start howling left. So you really have to power them up, don't you?
They're a very high speed disc, and I throw them hard for every shot.
Yeah.
So if I'm trying to vary the distance, it would only be because I'm throwing a big hyzer. Or a flick, or I just throw it lower.
Yeah.
So
it hits the ground earlier.
So it hits the ground earlier. Yeah. But if you've got a hard surface, you're going to get big skips with them.
Yeah.
But I really like them because they're fabulous just for sidearm as well as backhand.
Yep.
And like I say, they're good in the wind.
And the difference between them, you got one slightly
this one's a bit more overstable. That one's pretty just stable. It's a little bit older. They're both max weights, more or less, 172, 175.
And mostly you're throwing heavyweight discs, Simon?
Yeah, mostly.
Because you've got a big arm.
I did actually have a Blizzard in my bag, which I was throwing there for a while, around the 150 gram. Sadly, I lost it, and I haven't managed to replace it yet. But I do quite like a light disc, especially for uphills.
Yeah.
And if you're just getting a bit lazy and can't be bothered, throwing 175 grams. Yeah. But yeah, that... mostly all max weight. And finally, I've got this this lovely Star Destroyer here, which is my most overstable disc.
Yeah.
And I used to throw a max, but this is more overstable.
That's got some stuff written on it, Simon. Is there a bit of history in that disc?
Yes, there is. This was given to me by Marky San, which is a good friend of mine from Canada. And he signed it for me, even though it's a Patrick Brown, stamped disc. And... yeah, this is a great disc. If I've got a real big wind problems or I want a big hard S-shaped shot, I'll throw that and it's fast. So apart from that, all the other usual stuff.
Simon, do you throw any hammers?
Yep.
What do you like to hammer? X-Cal. Like
hammer, yeah. Rollers, I'll pull out the Roadrunner or
the Nuke even.
Yeah, you could roll the Nuke or you roll the Raptors and the Crows. But for forehand, the X-Cals are really good for rolling.
Because you can really power up the X-Cal with the sidearm without worrying it's going to flip on you.
You can give it a good hard push.
Outstanding. Hey, well, Simon, thank you so much for showing us through your bag. And and good luck with the next tournament. Are you going to Tamarunui?
No, unfortunately, I've got a wedding on, so no Tamarunui for me.
All right. What's the next one then?
Taronga.
All right, the Taronga Extreme.
Yep, which is one of my favourite courses.
So outstanding.
Come along.
We'll see you there.
Cheers.
See you.